balancing of several masses rotating in the same plane. So now we have number of masses, but they are rotating in the same plane. Now we have to balance them, right, by one mass. Consider any number of masses, right? It can be any number, say four. So now we have taken an example of four of magnitude m1, m2, m3, and m4. M1, m2, m3, and m4. At distances of r1, r2, r3, and r4. So r1, r2, r3, and r4. From the axis of the rotating shaft. From the axis of the rotating shaft. So this is the axis, okay? So this is like going inward to the slide. Let theta 1, theta 2, theta 3, and theta 4 be the angles of these masses. So since this is in one plane, it can be of any angle. So to mass 1, the angle is theta 1. For mass 2, angle is theta 2. For mass 3, angle is theta 3. And for mass 4, angle is theta 4, right? And for this balancing mass, that would be theta. Be the angles of these masses with the horizontal line OX. So here is the line OX, as shown in this figure. Let these masses rotate about an axis through O, right? Axis through O and perpendicular to the plane of the paper, right? So if this is the plane, this is going radially inwards with a constant angular velocity of omega radian per second, right? So this is rotating with a omega radian per second constant angular velocity. The magnitude and position of the balancing mass may be found out analytically or graphically as discussed below. So in these cases we can find the by two ways. Either it can be graphical method or analytical method, right? Both the ways can be used, right? We'll see how to find that one, right? So first one is the analytical method. All right, so this is for your reference. Let's see how to do that. The magnitude and direction of the balancing mass may be obtained analytically as discussed below. First of all, find out the centrifugal force exerted by each mass on the rotating shaft, right? So now we have to find the centrifugal force exerted by each mass on the rotating shaft. So we know how to find the centrifugal force Fc. What's the equation? Fc is equal to m r omega square, right? M r omega square. So centrifugal force each mass in rotating shaft. All right. Then resolve. So since we have four masses, we will have m1 r1 omega square, m2 r2 omega square, m3 r3 omega square, and m4 R4 omega squared, right? So it is given F1, F2, F3, F4, it is given. Then I have resolved the centrifugal forces horizontally and vertically and find their sums, right? So now you have the forces acting on several directions. Theta 1, it is acting this way. Theta 2, that is acting this way. Theta 3, that is acting this way. And theta 4, which is acting this way, right? So now we need to bring it to two directions, horizontal and vertical directions. All right, horizontal and vertical directions. So how will we do that? We will make it to that horizontal direction. If this is FC1, we will make it FC1 cos theta 1 will be x axis and sine theta 1 will be y axis, right? So we'll see how to do that. That is sigma h and sigma v. So sigma h is total in horizontal direction and sigma v is total in vertical direction. We know that sum of the horizontal components of the centrifugal forces is equal to sigma h m1 r1 cos theta 1, m2 r2 cos theta 2, and so on, right? So m1 r1 cos theta 1, right? Then m2 r2 cos theta 2, that is here m2 r2 cos theta 2. Then I have m3 r3 cos theta 3. So here I am putting plus. If the angle is in minus, then we can make it minus. So this is just like a general equation, I'm putting plus. All right. Similar way, some of the vertical components of the centrifugal forces can be divided into sigma v. right? That sigma v is in this way, you know, vertical axis. So that would be m1 r1 sine theta 1, m2 r2 sine theta 2, m3 r3 sine theta 3. It will be going like that, right? M1 r1 sine theta 1, m2 r2 sine theta 2. This will go like that. If we have found the sigma h and sigma v, we can found the resultant, right? We can find the resultant. Magnitude of the resultant centrifugal force Fc, that is centrifugal force, will be given by under root sigma h squared plus sigma v squared, that is horizontal force, addition of horizontal force, that is squared, plus addition of vertical force squared in square root, right? So this will give you the final resultant centrifugal force, right? And if theta is the angle which the resultant force makes with the horizontal, right? So now if you have find the centrifugal force, we need to say that what is the direction of that centrifugal force, right? So we can either give it with the angle, horizontal angle or vertical angle, right? So tan theta is equal to sigma v upon sigma h, that is addition of vertical forces divided by addition of horizontal forces. And this will give you the angle tan theta. The balancing force is then equal to the resultant force, but in opposite direction. So until now, right, until this step, we have found what is the resultant of all these four disturbing masses, right? So that resultant is here, it is acting somewhere here in this direction. It is known as Fc, right? So now it is enough to equalize this resultant force. So we will put another balancing mass on the opposite direction, right? This is the angle of resultant force. So we will put the balancing mass on the opposite direction, right? The balancing force is then equal to the resultant force, but in opposite direction. So here we will put a mass and R in a distance R, which will actually equalize the resultant force created by all these four masses, right? Now find out the magnitude of the balancing mass such that Fc is equal to mr. So now we know this value, that is the resultant value Fc, right? Now what we have to do is we can set a mass at a particular distance r which should equalize this equation Fc is equal to m into r. All right, so the m is balancing mass and the r is the radius, right? So this is how we will find balancing mass for number of masses rotating in a single plane, right? So this is one way, this is analytical method. We have graphical method also. Here we have a question, right? So this question is based on the example which you have studied now, several masses rotating in the same plane, right? So we have four masses, masses are given, rotation radius are given, angles are given, and the balancing mass where should be placed is also given. This is analytical method. So what we do, first we will find the forces caused by each mass, right? So these are given, right? Masses are given, radiuses are given, angles also given, right? So we are not talking about omega here. We will leave omega and we will go do the numerical only with m and r, right? So 200 kilogram is acting in 0.2 meter, that is 200 into 0.2, 40 kilogram per meter. 300 kilogram, which is acting in an angle of 0.15, so 300 into 0.15, 45 kilogram per meter. Then 240 acting in 0.25 meter, that is 240 into 0.25, 60 kilogram per meter. Then I have 260 acting in 0.3 meter, that is 260 into 0.3, 78 kilogram per meter. All right. Then, now, since we have found all the way forces, we will put them into equation horizontal, m1 r1 cos omega 1, right? So these angles are given, right? So m1 r1, we have already found 40 into cos 0, since this is in horizontal axis and we are taking angle horizontal, that is cos 0, that will become 1, right? So 40 into cos 0, 1, that is equal to 40. Then I have m2 r2 cos theta 2. M2 r2 is already found 45, and angle given 45. So cos 45, that is 1 upon root 2. So if you substitute 45 into 1 upon 2, that will bring you 31.8. And then I have 240 into 0.25, which is already given, 60 into cos 120. So since we are taking angle this way, but this is acting that way, so there will be a minus, right? So cos 120 will automatically bring you minus, that is minus 30, right? Cos 120 into 60 will bring you minus 30. And there I have 260 into 0.3. So we are looking into this direction, but this is acting that way. So that will bring another minus. So the angle is given 255, right? So 78 cos 255. So cos 255 will automatically bring a minus. So that is minus 20.2. So if you take the resultant, that will be 21.6 kilogram per meter. Now resolving vertically, right? We'll go vertically. So vertical means here we have a horizontal force. So that will be zero because sine 90 will be, sorry, sine zero will be zero. That is zero. Then I have 300 into this angle 0.15. That is 45 into sine 40, sorry, sine 45. That is again 31.8, right? 1.2. Then this one is also acting upwards. That is 60 into sine 120, right? 60 into sine 120. So that will bring another plus because that is also acting upwards, plus 52. And here I have a minus which is acting downwards, but I am taking the force upward. That is 78 into sine 255. That will give you 75.3 answer, right? So when you take the resultant, that will give you 8.5 kilogram per meter. So I have found the sigma h and sigma v. So the resultant will be found as under root square of horizontal forces plus vertical forces, right? That is 23.2 kilogram per meter. We know that mr is equal to r 23.2, or m is equal to 23.2 by r, because r is already given here. If its radius of rotation is 0.2 meters. So if the radius is given, how much should be the mass? That's the question. So when we divide it by 0.2, we will have 116 kilogram, right? 116 kilogram. And tan theta. So tan theta, I told you, sigma v upon sigma h, right? This angle upon this angle will give you the tan angle. Where will this force be acting? We don't know where will it act, right? It can act somewhere there or here, anywhere it can act. So tan theta is equal to sigma v upon sigma h, that is 8.5 upon 21.6. 8.5 upon 21.6. That will give you 0.39. That is theta is equal to 21.48, right? 21.48. Since theta dash is the angle of resultant r from the horizontal mass of 200 kilogram, therefore, the angle of the balancing mass from the horizontal mass of 200 kilogram would be 180 plus. Because if this is your resultant mass, that is 21.48 is the angle, then now we have found the resultant mass. So now the balancing mass will act on the other side, that is opposite to this one. So we will add 180 degree, right? 180 degree. So already we have 21.4 degree plus this 108 degree. That is 201.48 degree. This is the answer, right? 201.48 degree, right? So this is your final answer.